Hello there, and welcome back to my playthrough of Scholar of the First Sin. Left off here at the beginning of the Iron Keep with the possible promise of a PvP episode, but there don't seem to be any signs on this bridge, so I'll do that when I'm at a higher soul memory and I'm able to see more signs. There's a summon sign over there, but that's not what I'm looking for. I'm looking for red signs and dragon eyes. So I'll come back later. I also used most of the souls I had at the end of last episode in order to upgrade this large club. I went with this over the great club because it looks cooler, and hello there, NPC. Yeah, it's an NPC. That's an interesting addition, and I like it. Let's see what her AI is like. She's using a black flamestone dagger. Nope, that's not what she's using. She's using a spider fang in the right hand and a puzzling stone sword in the left. Which is an interesting combination. Are you gonna do anything there, hun? Yep, there you go. Alright. She doesn't seem too aggressive, which doesn't fit with the weapons that she's using, but oh well. Gonna do this until she dies, I think. Oops. This time, right? Let's try for a combo like this, yep. Let's see how much I can do with. Actually, let's try for a parry, see if I can't get one off. Oh, can't parry a jumping attack. Yeah, they really should have made this one's AI more aggressive. That fits the quick weapon she's got. Oh! She keeps spoiling my parrying attempts, though. Damn. Oh god. Oh, what? Okay. I feel like that really should have been a backstab, but whatever, game. There we go. Interesting addition, but definitely could have been a bit more difficult. And I don't get anything special, unfortunately. Oh well. But yeah, I upgraded the large club because I felt like using it, and I figured it would be good in this area since there's a lot of heavily armored enemies in this area, which will make strike damage even more effective than it usually is. Hello there. So they changed up the Alonne Knight placements a tiny bit, which I like. If you were playing this for the first time without any prior experience in Dark Souls 2, then it really wouldn't make a difference, but it does make quite a bit of difference if you have played the original version and you're expecting the original spawn locations. So far the changes here are more for people who played the original version, rather than other areas where it's more of a, where the changes work both for people who have and haven't played the original version. At least that's my take on it. And here we have Magarold, which is a really odd name. I have no idea what like culture that name is from, but looks like he sells the usual stuff. Yeah, he's got nothing new. I'll purchase this in case I end up needing it, and I definitely can't let those carvings go unpurchased, so let's pop a few souls. I got quite a few in my inventory. There we go, that should be enough to buy anything I want to purchase from him. Alright, there we go. Now, since I have a bunch of souls on me, and I could end up losing them, this next part is tough in the original version, and it might even be more difficult here, so I'm going to spend these souls. I'll definitely buy the Jester hat for farming purposes. I do actually like the Jester's tights, and they also have an additional effect. You know what, I'll just buy the entire Jester set. Maybe I could do Jester Thomas cosplay or something. I'll buy an effigy with the rest of my souls. And, a coin. There we go. Oh, and before I forget, I want to talk to him. I can get that gold, covered a serpent ring plus one since I spent enough souls. which will also help me if I ever need to farm up something. There's an illusory wall that I'm not gonna go through there, I'm gonna come through the opposite way. This is... If they haven't changed it, this will be the key to that door in the Forest of Fallen Giants. I could grab it after I turn off these statues, but if I position myself just right, I should be able to get it. Damn it. Because I went through that prompt so fast, I couldn't even tell what it said. I think it was very short. It's only like two couple little words. I think the second one was key, though. I'll check my key items and see if I can't recognize anything in there as that item I just picked up. Keep screwing up with the menus. So let's see. Okay, yep. Iron key, that's what I picked up. This iron door, too, must be somewhere far away. I think that's an added line. I'm pretty sure that wasn't there in the original version. I guess they added that to make it clear that you use it somewhere else other than the iron key. Which wasn't terribly clear in the original version. They must have, like, upped the drop rates across the board or something, because I'm getting a lot of drops. And I know what weapon I'm using next episode. I love the Black Steel Katana. It's probably my favorite katana. I would actually say... Oh, hello. I would say it is actually tied with the Bewitched Alonne Sword. It's a pretty close tie. And yeah, that's interesting. This is similar to the Black Gulch, where after killing one NPC, you can actually get another to spawn if you rest at the bonfire and go to roughly the same area. Successive NPC invaders, which is a very interesting concept. This guy's a spell spammer. Looks like he doesn't have... Oh, what? He's got the blue flame and he was jittering there for a second, which kind of freaked me the hell out. Let's see if I can get a... Yeah, look at him. Looking weird there. Let's see if I can get a guard break on him. Yeah, oh, there we go. And as he gets up... Okay, it's not gonna work. I'll just do... Ooh, I have to be careful. Okay, good, he used a shitty spell there. I can just take him out easily enough. And the way his movement works is a bit odd. Oh god damn, I'm getting wrecked by an NPC. Oh, he's actually using Soul Flash, that's interesting. And no drops, which is highly unfortunate. I wish that you would get unique items, like for him there, it'd be pretty cool if you could, say, get the blue flame. Be able to get it much earlier than the Undead Crypt, for example. But it doesn't seem that that is something they're going for. He dropped down before, I'm not sure how that happened. I guess I'll just, ignore him then. Take out his buddy here. And yeah, as I thought, the R2 does one-shot them, so that's what I should be using, rather than two R1s. It's more stamina efficient, I think. Especially since they fixed the durability bug, so using the R2 isn't gonna absolutely destroy this thing's durability. As it's attract him and retreat. In case there's a sniper. Oop, hello there. Oh, and guys from further away are coming in, too. Alright, thankfully it's not very difficult to deal with thanks to the OP-ness of the large club. Kind of a shame that they didn't alter enemy defenses so that strike weapons aren't quite so OP, but... Ah well, can't have everything. And I think that was the same item as before. And yeah, this you can get through this pod via this illusory wall. I just wanted to go through this backwards way. Alright, so that's it for here. Let's see what they've changed outside here. Well, I suppose this is technically still inside. No, it's outside. It's open to the sky. Counts as outside. Yeah, it's still got snipers after me. I think they're in the same positions. They removed an alonne knife from there, which, not quite sure why, because that combined with. Oh dear, this could get. Oh god, I got stunned there. This could get hairy. Okay, I survived. No, I didn't. Oh boy. So, they changed this area up a fair bit. They removed some of the alonne knights, but looks like they've added others a bit further away, but they aggro from a really far distance. Which actually makes them a bit more difficult to control compared to the original placements where you could get the knights to come out one by one and use the pillars as cover from these snipers. So I'm gonna have to be a bit more aggressive with my attacks and not miss anything if I want to get through that without dying, I think. Let's try that again. At least I gotta get up to it. I can't just run past the enemies because then they'll all be chasing me as like a horde. And that won't be fun to deal with. Alright, so that's where one came from, and there was one over here, wasn't there? I thought that's where one of them came from. Yeah, there's one over there, there's that guy. I thought there was a third one, but perhaps I'm mistaken. Oh, there he is. Okay. So he's also up there with the sniper, but he takes a while to aggro. But the fact that he aggroed from that far of a distance in the first place is very interesting because I don't believe there were any enemies that acted like that in the original version. You pretty much always had to approach them. The way that a bit of AI works is actually kind of reminiscent of the wandering enemies in Bloodborne. Oops, thought there was a knight there. How a lot of enemies in that game will actually wander around and sort of aggro to you even without you like approaching them, making things a bit more unpredictable. Which is a very good change, and it's one I hope that they keep in whatever future installments they make in the Soul series, or any other third-person action games that they make. But I really had my druthers then. From Software would make a third-person action game set in the Shadow Tower universe, because Shadow Tower games are some crazy shit. There's some real interesting enemy designs in the PlayStation one. Like a pile of cubes with body parts on each of the sides, and it's a demon that's like sealed in the cubes and other crazy shit. Okay, I'm going to retreat for a bit so I can get up a heal. Uh-oh. Okay, that was close. I did not deal with that as well as I ought to have. It's going good for a bit, but then I made a mistake and it nearly blew up in my face. So, before I try and press that switch, let's take care of this first sniper. It should ease up the pressure on me. I wonder if they've added any enemies down here at the bottom of this ladder. In New Game Plus, in the original version, there is a Black Phantom Alon Captain. And they did not add an enemy here, which is a bit unfortunate. And that is the same item placement as usual. Not an unwelcome one. Repair powder is always useful, especially considering it's also fairly expensive. And in the long term, I do have a limited number of souls with which to work with, since once I get to soul level 150 and get all my shit upgraded, I'm gonna be putting on the agape ring so I don't have to fight max level Havels in PvP. I do have to be careful about what I purchase. Relatively careful at any rate. And yep, life ring plus one and a twinkling titanite. Don't really care about the life ring, but the twinkle tits is very welcome. Okay, looks like that's all the knights I have to deal with, so I'm just gonna make the sniper whiff. Oh, hello! I didn't even notice that the sniper had changed positions. There was now a sniper on the bridge rather than over there in the distance, although it could just be me, but there does seem to be something up at the top there where the sniper used to be, but it's clearly not an enemy because it's not aggro to me. Maybe it's just a regular knight? Or a bit of pottery, not sure. I'll see when I get up there, I suppose. Yeah, it's just... Yeah, I was gonna take care of that guy, but kinda smoothed that up. That's just run away like a coward. Tactical retreats are important parts of winning any battle. If I were using a quicker weapon, I'd probably be a bit more aggressive, but if I miss a strike with this, I'm kinda screwed, so I'm being a bit more cautious than I would necessarily need to be. At least if I did things properly. Okay, and we still got an alonne captain right there. Oh, and a new addition there. Okay, this might be my death. Yep. If I had staggered my roll a bit, waited until the proper time, I could have survived, but it's a bit tough to tell when that alonne knight was going to attack due to the disappearing effect that the captain was pulling. But yeah, I should be able to ignore part of the enemies in that one. It depends really on how well they do end up aggroing to me. I did say this wasn't going to be a PvP episode, but since I see a red sign here, I'm going to risk those souls and see if I can't kill this duelist. As long as he's not... Sorry. As long as he's not a twink, I should be okay. Well, that, and as long as he doesn't run into the level when I get him down to low HP. That could be tricky to deal with. Let's see if I can still muster up some PvP skills, since it's been a bit since I've done PvP in this version. So what has he got? He's got some sort of... I think that's magic barrier. Given how he's using magic barrier as opposed to great magic barrier, I'm thinking that he's not a twink. Alright, so he's got some sort of sword. I think it's a long sword of some sort. And a hexing staff, I forget exactly what it's called. Yeah, he's not a twink. And I don't want to do R2s, I want to do jumping attacks, but I keep fucking up the timing. Okay, almost got that bait. Let's try it one-handed and go for a parry. Ooh, I actually hit that, I didn't expect that. Yeah, this guy's very aggressive, so I should be able to bait him into getting me a parry. There we go. Kept doing the same thing at the same time, it was inevitable. Alright, there we go, that was fun. Let's get back to the PvE portion then. Oh god damn it. It's kind of funny how much I'm getting wrecked by these stupid computer-controlled knights when I'm able to just take out another player with ease. Although, really, that's more due to the fact that that player wasn't terribly good. The absolute worst thing you can be in PvP is predictable. Because if you're predictable, then the other guy can easily get off a parry or a backstab anytime they choose. Doesn't matter what you do. Oh, I can't believe I missed that. Okay, now with this pot again. No. Yeah, definitely something working against me is my memory of the original placements. Like, I've run this pot so many times that I catch myself trying to run it like it's the original version, which isn't doing me any favors due to the different placements. That said, I'm doing quite well at the moment. Knock on wood. Okay, yeah, there's another guy running at me, so taking this pot aggressively once you get the bridge down definitely seems to be a good idea. Take out that sniper and you can take out the knights as they end up coming after you. I'd say I definitely do like these changes. There's been very few changes they've made that I haven't liked. In fact, I can't even think of any at the moment. The fact that you have these knights all dispersed around the area, but they aggro to you as soon as you get to around here is really nice. It really encourages you to be a bit more aggressive with taking them out. Something that, the previous games don't really do all that much. And I got my sword. Oh, meant to do a, backstab, but ended up working out for me that I did a regular attack, I was able to pick out both of them. Oh god, I forgot they have curving arrows. Let's get him to fire off a shot and then I'll jump over and take him out. God. Wait. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. This is not how I expected it to be. I'm running away. Hopefully I won't get sniped in the back. Oh, I'm dead. Okay, that is very interesting. For one, you don't need to make a jump there. I thought that there was still a bit of that, platform just sort of gone, like it was in the original version, but nope, it's just one flat platform that you can walk across. You don't need to jump. Two, in addition to the sniper, there was, it looked like, one alonne knight behind him, and then one on top of the, area above who immediately dropped down after me. So that is interesting. Let's see if I can't do it this time. Hopefully this will be my last death before getting up to smell the demon. Well, I should be able to take out without dying because I have very good damage output for him, and smell the demon isn't very tricky if you know his attacks. So as long as they haven't updated him at all, and I doubt that since they haven't done that to any other bosses so far, I should be fine against him. Once again, knock on wood. Alright, so take out these guys. Yeah, already I'm getting used to the placements, so I'm able to get through this part rather smoothly. As long as I don't miss. Gonna let my stamina recover and then blitz to the sniper on the bridge. Try what I did last time. One out. Two, I forgot that the follow-up archer was a multi-hit, which I was only able to get the first hit off, so that nearly screwed me up. Oh, there we go, that's another one taken out. And then there should be two more coming this way, if I remember correctly. Yep, there's one, and then there's two. Where exactly are they coming from? I guess they're coming from further beyond there, but I swear I didn't see them there. I guess they just must be hard to see from this distance. Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna take out this part first. I would consider dropping down to take care of that guy so I'd have somewhere to flee to, but I should be fine taking out this part first. Oh god. Nope, I'm dead. Holy shit, that was close. I got sniped by that sniper, stunned by him, and just ended up getting hit by that other alonne knight who's pretty damn aggressive on me. Oh god. I very much like the addition of a few more snipers. The fact that they have one on the bridge and then one over there now. It's an extra one, and that really makes this last part. It turns it from a cakewalk it used to be to actually pretty difficult. Alright, so I already turned off the fire so I can go back through there and hopefully take out those last few alonne knights. Let's see if there's any enemies in here. God damn it. Okay, there is not. I was curious about that because in the original version there were not enemies in this room in New Game, but there were in New Game Plus. That's sort of, that is one thing I'm on the lookout for, if they perhaps moved any of the New Game Plus placements from the original version to New Game in this version. So far it doesn't seem like they have, at least I haven't noticed it if they have done it. Yeah, it's something I'm keeping an eye out for. Okay, so yeah, wait, what happened to the sniper? Is he down there? What? I can't figure out where his arrows are coming from. Oh, that's the guy who's sniping me. So, there was a sniper over there. I guess maybe he either fell off into the lava and I didn't notice, or he was one of the alonne knights that ended up bum rushing me. Like, I got close enough to aggro him or whatever. Well, that's that bit dealt with. And they removed the iron chest that had the Zweihander. Yeah, chest not here. Impossible. That's kind of unfortunate. I hope it's somewhere else in this zone, because the Zweihander is a pretty cool weapon. Oh, that was close. I nearly missed that there. Okay, and they replaced the dull ember, since they moved that to the Bastille. They replaced it with a dragon bone, which is good. Having more of them is not a bad thing. Oh, hello, is this the Zweihander? Aha, I actually like that placement change. They put enemies there, and then they move the chest up here. We actually have to go through a bit more to get it. You have to do a bit of platforming, so it's a bit more difficult to get. Alright, so far, I like the changes that they've made, as always. I'm not gonna try and jump to that item because I don't remember it being particularly worthwhile in the original version, and while they could have changed it, I'm not risking having to go through this part again if I fail and die. And I'm probably gonna, because see how level it is with this platform here and the bridge? It's very difficult to make that jump. You have to have very precise timing, so not risking it. Gonna stand here so I'm out of range of that sniper and put some buffing items on my hotbar. I'm tempted to go with poison, but the club does not hit fast enough for me to be able to proc it reliably, so I'll go with aromatic ooze. And I will save that for his third phase so I can take out that phase as quickly as possible. I get one attack off here initially and then we can do something, yep. So yeah, he's the same as always, it seems. Oh, don't want to do that, because he does that delayed AoE that catches so many people. Sunblowing for this boss is just the absolute worst, because, like, I would say 7 or 8 out of 10 hosts get caught by this AoE. And when I say they get caught by this AoE, I don't mean once. That's excusable. If you're fighting them for the first time, why would you expect that? It looks like an opportunity to attack him. No, when I say they get caught by it, I mean they get caught by it repeatedly, like 2, 3, even 4 times, and it usually eventually ends up killing them. And that's why sunburning for this boss is just an absolute pain in the ass. It really is ridiculous how some people just don't learn the patterns, even when it's like something pretty damn obvious and easy to avoid. Like you just gotta walk away when he does it. Yeah, Smelty here is going as easy as ever. He's nearly dead and he hasn't even entered his third phase. Which is rather interesting, like usually he's entered it by now, he usually enters it at around half HP. Is he actually not going to enter it? That's an interesting change. At first I had thought that maybe he wasn't going through it because I had, depleted his HP fast, but like, and so it's taking longer to phase change, but it seems like he's not going to his third phase at all. Yeah, in his third phase he has the flame aura that makes you constantly take damage when you're near him. I wonder if perhaps they removed that because people complained about it. If that is the case, that's rather disappointing, because Like, while people did complain about it, it wasn't a bad element. It encouraged you to be really aggressive with him whenever you get up close to hit him. Oop. Speaking of which, I didn't even notice he was doing the AoE there. I got so distracted. But yeah, it is a shame that they removed his third phase, because it was interesting not only because of the AoE, but also because his attacks actually changed to do pure fire damage, which means that if you managed to get 900 fire defense, you would take effectively no damage from him, because you'd have a 99% resistance to fire. Yeah, it's unfortunate that they changed that. That is a change I very much do not like. Although, it is possible that that is not actually a change, that his AI just ended up glitching out in an odd way, preventing him from going to his third phase. That's always a possibility, and I hope that is indeed the case. But yeah, that should be it for this episode, so thanks for watching, and see you next time.